Myself Sneha Modi, member of Outreach Club, Film and Media Council, iitbhu. It's my privilege to introduce you guys to our guest of honor, Shri Hari Babu Srivastava. Mr. Srivastava, being an outstanding scientist, great academician, and a keen researcher, took over as Director General, Technology Management on 31st May 2021. Prior to taking over as DG, Shri Hari Babu Srivastava was Director of Laser Science and Technology Center, New Delhi. An alumnus of IIT Roorkee and IIT Kanpur, he has authored or co-authored many technical papers in various national and international field journals, apart from numerous internal DRDO reports. Thank you so much, sir, for being here.
Thank you.
So should we start with questions?
Yeah, please go ahead.
How was your experience at Technex 2023?
Firstly, iitbhu is a wonderful institution. I've been here a couple of times earlier, and all the times when I've gone back, I've gone back with good memories. And the kind of organization that you people have done with the robotics show and all that was on display yesterday felt very good. This nation is in good hands, good young hands, doing good work in technology. I'm sure you people will do well.
Also, sir, what influenced you to choose your career in the field of research?
That's a good question. Usually people will like to go to services and manufacturing and mostly marketing. Choosing research is something which is very, it has to come from inside. It is not that somebody can tell you that you do research and you can do it. If you really want to take challenge in life, I think research is the career. And out of 20, 30, 40 years that you do your work, if you can make just one difference somewhere in some technology, I think that will be satisfying for the whole of your life. So I think that is the motivation that I had, and of course nurtured by my gurus and all that. And that is how I've gone into this field.
Continuing the question, as you know, nowadays most of the engineering students prefer IT sector, and only a small strand of it chooses to get into research field and code. So how can we increase opportunities in research and core engineering to attract talents in those sectors?
So actually government is doing a lot of work in this area. Earlier, of course, one thing is that the driver is money, first of all. And IT career was giving a lot of money to students. You graduate in whichever field, do a little bit of work in computer science, computer languages, and private companies will come and take you to the IT field. It is no more so that every student is going to the IT sector, but yes, that trend has to be plugged. Yeah. And government is doing a lot of work in that area by giving a lot of opportunities, a lot of funds.
India is one of the biggest importers of arms, and some of our key weapons such as Rafale were ordered from foreign nations. How can we decrease reliance on other nations' technology and promote Make in India in our defense sector?
The government has a full determination of making this other way around. We will become the major exporter of the equipment, military equipment. And towards that end, the government has already set a line. By 2025, India will export defense equipment worth $5 billion US. What happens is a bigger platforms, like for example what you talked about Rafale, they cost a large amount of money. And even if you procure some 10 numbers or 20 numbers, the whole budget becomes skewed. So that is why you see sometimes this becoming large percentage of import in terms of money. But in terms of equipment, if you see, a large number is going through Indian thing.
So is your work life hectic? Like, what do you prefer to do in your free time?
So I write poetry, and I have two pastimes. One is writing, another is listening. So I listen to a lot of religious discourses, and my favorite is Valmiki Ramayana.
What is the future of India in R&D of defense technology?
So as I said earlier, the government has planned to make everything indigenous. 90% requirements to be met by indigenous weapon systems, and also export. Now defense export is a very challenging task, because one is that the services required the best, that is which can operate at high altitude, which can operate in deserts, which can go under the water, ocean, and everything has to work under all the kind of conditions, whether it is minus 40 degrees Celsius temperature or plus 55 degrees Celsius. So the requirement of technology is very, very intense. That is one. You cannot sell it unless your equipment is world class. It has to go through the competition with the world powers. Number two is, you can sell only that item for which you own the IP. If you don't own the IP, if you procure the IP from somewhere, you are restricted, you cannot sell it. So both these things put together require you to do a lot of work, and we have to all go through. DRDO will take help from all people, and DRDO will support all people. Finally, the aim is indigenous equipment going into our Indian Army, Indian Air Force and Indian Navy, and making our adversary frightful. That is the aim.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.